There's been a lot of bad ones.
The worst show that I've ever played in my career is probably a Colorado Springs festival that we didn't know was a white power support festival. We rolled in and played our set, and after our set realized that all the people who were digging our band were white power dudes who were just released or like were doing a benefit show for their dude who just got out of jail, which is like three blocks down. So these bikes show up and all these dudes, and we just got the f- out of there because it was awkward and uncomfortable, to say the least. And it was either try to fight a whole room of Nazi dudes or just leave. And it just took a high point of like having a good show to this low point of like, damn, the kids that are here to see us are the worst kids in the world.
The one that comes to mind at the moment was when we were playing Atlanta, Georgia, I believe, and it was like torrents of rain and just everything was coming down. And I get up to go play on stage, and I found out that the forklift bringing my gear up, my racks, up onto the stage had dropped my rack on its side, and all I could get was this super bass heavy kind of fuzz tone, like maybe something out of, you know, the 70s, you know. And then here I gotta go and I gotta jump on stage and play this metal in your face, sharp attack kind of sound music. And the whole show, it was just that tone, this flubby, tubby, fuzzy tone. And I had to go out there and pretend like I was putting on the best show ever. And it was pretty funny though, because in a way, I was able to let go of any trepidation. I was like, it is what it is, you know, my tone is not going to be what I want it to be. So I think I was able to perform fairly well, but I know it sounded horrible. So, sorry guys.
Probably one of my worst shows, and it wasn't even the other dudes in the band, it was more just me. I tried to order a burrito in French, which already is wacky because having Mexican food, but ordering it in French, we were in Canada, and I got really, 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 really sick, and I puked all over myself during the set, completely ruined the set and any chance of saving it, and then I had to play the whole set with puke on myself. It was great. That was fun.
There was one show we played, this was like a long time ago, but we played it at this house that was like kind of like a crack house or something. We were like little kids and we played, and like everyone was there for like a party. It was like typical, like when you're a little kid trying to go on tour and you just play some like guy's like party. And we had to have Joe, who was not in the band at the time, go around and like get people to like pay so we could at least just get gas money. And he literally was in like with us going around getting everybody to pay. It was pretty insane. It was horrible.
Augusta, Georgia, Halloween. We were drinking all day. We were drinking this punch that Toxic Holocaust made. What did they call it? Not toxic tea, toxic something. But anyway, it was like green slime colored, and it was basically like a jungle juice kind of scenario, you know, with like every white liquor poured into it probably. And everybody got hammered. Ryan Knight, who was our lead player at the time, and Woody, who was our sound guy at the time, they went out and went to the strip club and came back blacked out. And we're about to start the show. And we're dressed up as these, we tried to do like a Village People scenario, but there weren't that many costumes left. So we were the busted, the worst Village People ever. So we played, and Woody's blacked out, he's trying to mix, and he's turning the show into like Merzbow back there, just like pushing everything. He can't hear, he doesn't know what's going on. So Kareem comes up, he's our tour manager at the time, he works for Indie Merch now. He has to like take the knobs, he doesn't know what the f*** he's doing, but I mean it's going to be better than Woody, because Woody's just straight up like, you know, turning every knob all the way up, like the Back to the Future amplifier or something. And so that's happening. Then we play, and we're all so wrecked that it's like a Sex Pistols show. Like, everyone's out of tune, we're like falling all over the place. Like, it's literally the worst show you could possibly ever see. And any time luckily there was probably 100 or less people there. So I don't run into people that know about it that often, but when they do, I cringe and I apologize. I want to like take down their address and like send them a card because it was the worst show of all time.
We played this one show one time. It's 120,000 people. 120,000 people. It's a lot of fucking people. And they didn't give a fuck. It was like playing to an oil painting. And we just played and we played our fucking, and I tried every trick in the fucking book to get him to go crazy and do anything. And they just stood there and they just didn't care because they were waiting for the other band to come on. And I was like, man, ain't that some shit right there? Like one of the biggest crowds we've ever played to. And people were just like that the whole time. I was like, that sucks. So, you know, like they always ask like, hey, what would you rather play? A fucking huge festival or whatever. To me, you can play a show to 500 people, and if those 500 people are losing their mind, it can be the most life-affirming shit you've ever experienced.